Hello, welcome to the Weber Dojo. Because we can't train in our normal dojo, we decided to create these videos to help our students follow along and keep their training up at home. If you may notice that we will not include any new material in these videos because we want to make sure that everyone in the dojo can follow along. We have a wide variety of students, so we want to make sure that everyone is able to train. You may notice that we will include higher level of difficulty in some of our drills, and we will be sure to note that in the training.
We're going to start this training with a warm-up and then conclude it with a cool-down. So make sure that you're doing that on your own in future videos because those will not be included. All right, let's get started. Okay, we're gonna get started. First, gonna start off with a warm up. So, let's move the fingers around, wrists out of the way, elbows. Out. Circle. Reverse. Heel kicks. Do these as if you're thinking about doing a snapback on your kicks. Get the blood flowing to the lower body. Right knees up. And rotate out. And rotate in. And hips around. Other way. All right, your right arm across. Switch your left. Your right arm back. And bend to your left. Yep. All right, switch your arms. And bend to your right. And back up. At shoulders. And back. Hips again. Reverse. All right, neck around. Reverse. Here your shoulder. And look side to side. All right, stepping out to your left. Nice long front stance, can be narrow. Try to keep your hips the same level, close to your front knee. All right, now we're going to kind of pulse. First motion is down. So each, knee, san, shi, go, rook, sich, hach, ku, and ju. All right, hips 90. Again, try to keep your hips even with your front knee. Warrior position, so keep your biceps close to your ears. And pulsing again. First motion is down. Ich, ni, san, shi, go, rook, teach, hutch, coo, and jew. And chest forward. Forward hand grabs your forward ankle. Straighten both legs. Other hand straight up to the sky. And sitting back on your back leg. Try to keep your heels down, toes up. And other direction. Right. Again, hips, try to keep them close to the same level as your front knee. Right. Turn 90. Right. Biceps close to the ear, reach to the sky. And pulsing each knee. Sun, she. Go, rook, sitch, hutch, coo, ju. And chest forward. Front hand grabs the ankle, straighten your legs. Opposite hand straight to the sky. And sitting back, right, heels down. And jump your feet together, toes and ankles. Right, sitting back, butterfly. Right, try to pull the heels in tight, keep your back straight. And chest forward. And butterfly. Right, from here, bring your right knee up. Keep your rear end off the floor and press your chest into your bent knee. So for future videos, we're not going to do this warm-up, so you can either refer back to this video or make sure you get some kind of little warm-up before your training and then again at the end or conclusion of your training. Let your foot drop, twist to your right, twist to your left. Twist back. And release. Alright, set your feet. Press your chest in. Let your foot drop. Alright, twist to your left. To the right and twist back and release. Right, holding the squat, right, stepping out. Try to keep your hips even with your knees. Push out on your left side, drop the left shoulder. Switch out to the right. Switch. And switch. Right, roll the hips forward. Press out on both knees. Posture straight. And from here, pulsing. First motion down. Each knee. Sun. shi, go, rook, sich, hutch, ku, and ju. Hold it. And coming back up, hips around. Reverse. One more time. Tighten your knees together. Small circles. Other way. And straight. Alright, turn and adjust your gi. And turning back. Right feet together. Right. And ready. Okay, so today we're going to assume that you don't have a whole lot of room at home to train. So taking that into consideration, try to make sure best that you can. If you can get one step forward, one step back, and a step in either direction, you should be pretty good with the trainings that we're going to be doing today. For me, it's about a 6 foot square, so that's what we're going to try to keep everything contained to. So the first thing we're going to do is we're working our stances. So from here, we're going to squat down and focus on keeping your posture straight, so your shoulders over your hips. So when we come in for our front stance, you're going to keep your hips about the same level, and then we're going to switch. Okay? So Sensei Golden always told us, always think down and in. So that's our first motion, is going to be down and then coming forward or going back as we progress through this. Okay? So, first motion, stepping forward. So ready, ich. And we're gonna switch our feet. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Sich. Hatch. Ku. Ju. Ayame. I'm going to turn a little bit so you can see. So now we're going to go back. So as we go down, try not to go too far back with your posture. You want to keep your posture straight. So the best you can, when you're bending your knees, keep your torso closer to the front leg. Okay? So stepping back, we're going to go left leg back first. Ready? Ich. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Sich. Hutch. Ku. And ju. Yame. Alright, next one is going to be back stance. So, same idea. We're going to go down and in first, and then we'll go back. Alright, this time starting with the right leg. Ready? Ich. Try to keep the weight back best you can. Ready? Ni. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Sich. Hutch. Ku. Ju. Yame. Alright, same idea. Going backwards this time. Ready? This time, left leg starts. Ready? Ich. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Sich. Hutch. Ku. Ju. Yame. All right, hips around if you need it. As always, if your body needs certain stretching in between, pause the video, do your stretches, and then come back with us. All right, so now those are the two basic stances that we're going to be working with. We're going to add some upper body techniques with those. So first one, I mean, these are all going to be very basic because we're trying to accomplish a lot with white belts all the way up through black belt in the club. So work as you need, what your body needs, what your rank needs. Put a little more emphasis towards this. All right, stepping forward with do the right leg forward this time. So down block, ready? Each, knee, sun, sheep, go, rook, sitch, hutch, coop, jill, yummy. All right, this time we're gonna go back. All right, left leg stepping back first. Ready? Itch. Knee. Sump. Shake. Go. Rook. Seach. Hutch. Cook. Joe. Yummy. All right, upper belts. Think about performing the techniques quicker, right? I'm gonna still stay at this same pace, so at the lower ranks, don't get too confused. All right, stepping in, this time we're gonna do rising block. Ready? Itch. Knee. Sump. She. Go. Rook. Six, hot, coop, two, down there. Height going backwards. Step back with your right leg this time. Ready? Itch, knee, sump, she, go, rook. Teach. Ouch. Coop. Joe. Yummy. All right, hips around. All right, this time, middle block. All right, step in with your right leg this time. All right, ready? Itch. Knee. Top. She. Go. Rook. Seek. Touch. Coop. Jump. Alright, going backwards this time. Stepping back with your right leg this time. Ready? Itch. Knee. Sump. Sheep. Go. Rook, sitch, hutch, coop, do. That hips around. All right, this time back stance, kokuts. All right, stepping back with your left leg this time. All right, shuto, okay. All right, ready? Itch. Knee. Sump. She. Go. Rook. Teach. Hutch. Coop. Jill. Yummy. Hey, stepping back. I'll step back left side this time. Ready? Itch. knee. Sam. Chi. Go. Rook. Sich. Hutch. Coop. Jill. Come in. And hips around again. Alright, so now with the we're going to build upon it more. So with each block, we're going to add a counter punch. Alright, so the down block, you're going to counter punch. Everything will be at chew down level. Okay? Alright, so stepping forward, left side this time steps forward. Alright, ready? Itch. Knee. Sump. Go. Rook. Teach. Hutch. Cut. Do. Hey. Down. Okay, stepping back. Let's step back left side first. Ready? Itch. Knees. Sump. She. Go. Rook. Sitch. Hatch. Coop. Do. Hey. Yummy. And hips around. All right, now, rising block. All right, ready? Step back right side this time. Itch. Knee. Sump. She. Go. Rook. Sitch. Hutch. Coop. Do. Alright, this time going forward with a middle block. Right. Forward with the right leg. Ready? Itch. Knee. Sump. Sheep. Go. Rook. Sitch. Hutch. Coop. And stepping back, right leg. Ready? Itch. Knee. Sump. She. Go. Rook. Sitch. Yummy. And hips around again. All right, next one is kokuts. Shutoke, and then change to front stance, zenkuts, with a punch. All right, ready? Stepping back with right leg. Itch. Knee. Let's go forward. Alright, my bad. Step forward, left leg. Alright, ready? Itch. Knee. Sump. Shit. Go. Rook. Sitch. Now, let's go back. Right leg forward, or right leg back first. Ready? Each. Knee. Sat. She. Go. Rook. Teach. Touch. Kiss. Two. Quit. Yummy. And hips around. More advanced students, you can add kicking to these techniques, front kicking, side kicking, anything that it's going to make it a little more challenging for you. Stay healthy. Make sure you're still training during this this time. And I'm going to turn things over now to Sensei Kim Weber. Thank you.
Thank you, Sensei, for a good training. So my training now is going to include different versions of Heian Shodan. So at first we will do Heian Shodan regular, normal imbusin. So if you're in a smaller space, I'm going to show you how to adapt that kata for you. If you have more space, be sure to use the entire room. In my kata, when I'll be practicing today, I'll only have to adjust a couple of times. So you may have to adjust every step. So let me show you a version of what it would look like if you have to adjust every step. If you're basically going to train in one step in each direction, if that's all the space that you have. All right, so for Heian Shodan. So the first move you should be able to do correctly. Then what I'd like for you to do is I'd like for you to pull your support foot back to your stepping foot so that the second half of the technique that you're performing is correct and similar to what you usually do. So in this case, I will pull my support foot back and I'll step and punch. So the next one, if I can't turn completely, I will pull my foot up, my support foot, my pivot foot, and then turn, rotate, and make the down block. This next kensui should be able to be performed as normal. And then pull your foot back, support foot back, and punch. This next technique should be able to be performed as usual here. Then you'll pull your step, your support foot back, rising block. Pull your support foot back, rising block. Last one, hup! This next technique should be able to be performed as normal. Then pull your support foot back, punch. If you need to adjust here, pull your support foot back, and then step. Pull your support foot back, and then step. Next turn. Then do the same thing throughout the punches. Rotate. And then the same with the kokutsudachi. Pull your support foot back, then step. This next technique you should be able to do in place. And then pull your support foot back and step. And bow. So when you're making adjustments like this, you may not end up on your mark completely. That's okay. So because you're adjusting your stance every time. So now let's do Heian Shodan again, and we're gonna make it a little more difficult. I want you to add counter punch to every step you take, every technique that you do. So let me show you an example. Heian Shodan. So you do the technique, counter punch. Now you're going to have to pull back the punch so that you can do oizuki as is in the kata. So I will pull back, punch, then counter punch. And again, if you have to adjust your feet, that's also something, an adjustment that you'll have to make. I, in my space, don't have to do that, so I'm going to do the complete kata as best I can so that students can follow along a little bit better and understand where we are. So then the next technique, step, down block, punch. Then you have to put your hand back down to perform the hammer fist strike. punch, then punch, punch. Okay, so if you understand, let's go through the entire kata. I will be performing the kata at slow speed. You're welcome to speed up, intermediate and advanced. You can speed up the count, the speed of your technique if you wish. All right, so let's start. And shodan. Ich. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Sich. Hatch. Ku. Ju. Ich. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Sich. Heh. Hatch. Ku. Ju. Ich. Yame. Bow. All right, relax. Move your hips around. Reach down. And reach. Okay, so now we're going to do another version that includes a counter kick. So the kata will look like this. Do the technique, then do a back leg front kick, return the foot. So when we reach the shuto-uke, I would like for you to follow that as well. So you're going to bring your weight to your front leg, kick in the direction that you're facing. So in this instance, my right leg kicks in this direction where my blocking hand is. So I want to kick and then end up back in Kokutsudachi. Same thing. This time my kick's gonna go in this direction and then land back in Kokutsudachi. If you're a beginner level and you just wanna do the kata, you don't wanna add the kicks, that's okay. Intermediate and advanced, you should be able to follow along. All right, let's try. Right. Hand shodan. Ich. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Sich. Hatch. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Sich. Hey. Hutch. Ku. Ju. Ich. Yame. Okay, relax. Okay, so now what I want to do is I want to combine both the punch and the kick to hand shodan. So it'll look like this. You'll do the first technique, then you'll do a punch, and then a kick. You can keep your punch out here for the kick. But then remember, you have to change when you do the step and punch. So you're going to pull your right hand back so you can do a step and punch as it is in the kata. So the technique from the kata, then punch, kick. Then your next technique is to turn behind you and do a down block. So you'll step, down block, punch, kick. Then technique, punch, kick. So it might be a good idea in your mind every time to say, when I count, say technique, punch, kick. So I'm just going to count the count. And again, I'm going to count at a slower pace so that those that might be having difficulty figuring it out can follow along. If you know what you're doing, you can go speed and focus and then just wait for me for the next count, but stay in the position. So you always want to make sure, especially since nobody's in the dojo, no, you don't have an instructor correcting you, you want to work on being as perfect as you can. So this is about quality, maybe not necessarily quantity. So every stance, good draw hand, things like that, okay? So make sure that you take the responsibility to improve. That's something that you have to do yourself. All right, let's get started. Great. Hand shodan. Each. So technique, punch, kick. Knee. San. She. Go. Rook. Seach. San. She. Go. Rook. Seach. Up. Hutch. Coop. Jew. Yame. Right? I know. Sometimes you don't mean to ki, it just comes out. So that's okay. All right, relax. Hips around. Breathe in and out. Back and in. Okay, the next version of hand shodan will be normal, regular, without the added techniques. I want you to go as fast as you can for each count. I will keep my pace slower so that those that need a little more time can follow along. Hand shodan. Ich. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Ichi. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Seat. Et. Hutch. Ku. Ju. Ichi. Yame. Right? Okay, and relax. Okay, now we're gonna start our cool down section. So we're gonna go through Heian Shodan one more time. This time, I don't want you to think about making a lower, longer stance. I want you to think about stretching your hamstrings, making a long stretch. So make sure that for this one, even if you didn't have to adjust the last time, you may have to adjust your stance. This is going to take up more room. For those that are able to, you want to make a smooth transition from stance to stance. So you don't want to go from the second move and go come up and then go down. You want to try to keep your height the same if you can. So struggle to do that. Make it look smooth and like you're doing it on purpose. Okay? Ready? Right? Heian Shodan. Ichi. So lower, longer. Just think stretch your legs. Ni. I might leave out of the frame a little bit here. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Siich. Hach. Ku. Hey. Ju. Ich. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Siich. Hach. Ku. Ju. Ich. Ni. Yummy. Okay. So now let's do some cool down exercises. Your body should be warmed up from Sensei Jeff Weber's training and my training. So now's a good time to work on flexibility. Right? So hips around. Put your toes together. Put your fingers under your toes. Bend your knees. Straighten. Ni. San. Shi. Go. Rook. Siich. Hach. Ku. Ju. Now, keep your heels together. Separate your toes. Let's do it again. Ichi, ni, san, shi, go, rook, siich, hach, ku, and ju. Okay, now change, bring your toes together, put your heels out. Let's do that one more time. Ichi, ni, san, chi. Go. Rook. Siich. Hach. Ku. And you. So I want to thank our friend, Sensei Carol Glenn. She's the Mid-America team coach. I want to thank her for that drill. Right. Squat down. Stretch your toes. Right. Put your hands on the ground. Straighten your legs. Flatten your feet into downward dog. You want to push back into your hips, into your feet. And then you can take turns walking your feet. So you're going to take turns raising up one heel or the other. You should be able to feel a good stretch in your hamstrings. All right, knees back on the ground and sit. Butterfly, feet together. Press your knees to the ground. If you can do it without the use of your elbows pushing down something, that's okay. Do that. Or you can hold on here. This is your elbows. You use your elbows to push your knees down. And then one more time. Okay, now for this one, stick your left leg out and keep your right foot in. I want you to reach past your foot. I don't want you to grab a hold of your ankle and pull your body down. I want you to think of this as I'm reaching past my foot to try to touch something over there. In the process, you're bringing your chest to your leg, not your nose to your knee. Okay, so here. Up, switch your legs. You might find that one side is a little more flexible than the other. Same thing, I reach on the outside. And up. Now we're going to put our feet out. I want to start with saying that if you have very inflexible, if your hamstrings are tight, just make sure that your posture is up. I don't want you slouching back like this. If you're trying to get your legs farther apart, sometimes that might create a slouch in your back. So I'd rather have your feet closer together and have you sitting upright, like your back is up against a wall. So if this is where you are, this is where you are. Just keep it here and then just work on the stretch as you can here. As far as your feet, I prefer them to just be natural, because if you're pulling in or pointing out, you're using tension in your legs to try to hold that position. You're tensing the muscles. I'd rather have your legs just relaxed. All right, so go to the position that you need to go to get the best stretch for you, and then relax forward. Stand back up, put your left arm across. Change. Change. And change. If there's any part of a stretch that we've not done in our video, make sure that if you need it, make sure that you take care of your body. If you need stretching more for your lower back or your neck or your hamstring or your quads, something like that, make sure that you include that on your own. We try to do a general stretch, warm up and cool down. So make sure that you do what you need for your body. All right, thank you.
We want to thank everybody for joining us for our first virtual training. It's been kind of a work in progress for us, but we want everybody to stay healthy and keep training.
All right, we hope to see you back here soon. Bye.